Encyclopedia, Magic 20. boxes. And then, of course, it shows you that you can purchase individual booster packs. They contain 15 cards so that you can add and customize your deck and collect more cards. And then you can see the introductory packs here. These are all already ready to play 60 card decks that you can purchase for around $10, I think, in that approximate ballpark. So I recently started to take interest in this again. We've been playing Pokemon with our son since he was 4. He's going to be 6 in a couple months. So a couple nights prior to the date of this video, I brought out a couple of Magic the Gathering decks that I have, and we played, and he was able to play. He can't read the names of the monsters and things like that because those are very complicated words for him, but he understands the gist of the game because it's somewhat similar to Pokemon. But it's, of course, more advanced, and I think it's better. So if my 5-year-old son can play, you can see it really, it's you can keep it real basic so that anybody can play. All right, so let's just open this up here real carefully. can see blue, white, blue, red, green, and there's a, I think there's supposed to be black, plague, there's green, and these are all different powers, green, yeah, there's black. Black, if you feel a strong pull toward the stability of order and the purifying light of law, then you are attuned to white mana, where strength in numbers and the well-being of the community are paramount. So it tells you about, you know, if you want to play white cards. I guess they're calling them by their colors because it used to be like plains, water, swamp, or plague, but blue, if you are drawn toward illusory realms, I guess that's how you say illusory, it's illusion, but it's, I never really knew how to pronounce that word, illusory realms of subterfuge and the pursuit of ultimate knowledge, then you are inspired by blue mana, the unfathomable depths of the ocean. And the mind await you. And each, these are different powers, types of cards that you would play. Mana is the energy that the card, it's like the card types. Instead of like a typical deck of cards is red, you know, red of diamonds, red of heart, queen of diamonds, queen of hearts, those are red cards. It's kind of the same thing here. Black, red, blue. They represent certain types of creatures and spells. And here's black, if you are unafraid to explore the dark realms for fiendish power, then you crave to be steeped in black mana. Horrors await your command, and all your mad ambitions can reign unchecked. And there's red, and there's green, the forest, and such. Artifacts or certain items, objects that you can use. Land cards. Land is where you draw your mana in order to cast spells. Let's see here. The 10 coolest magic 2013 cards. And then card encyclopedia for 2013. So apparently these are all the cards they created for 2013. Looks like there's 249 unique cards. Here is a card list. It tells you how common, uncommon, common, rare, etc. Mythic, rare. You'll probably never find that. Very rare. Rare, uncommon, common, regular card, premium card, basic land. And a land card just means it's a card. It's a regular. Now most of them are all land cards. Regular cards. Land cards. So most of these are all regular and premium cards. I'm not sure what the difference is between regular and premium, but they all look like they're the same. Anyway, all right. So that's the player's guide. I don't really see anything here. Let's see. Exploring the. Let's see. Let's just read a little bit about it one last time before we get into the decks, because we're already halfway through the video. The Magic the Gathering game expands every year, introducing new worlds filled with deadly perils, ancient adversaries, and fantastic new adventures. At its center is the Magic core set, the game in its purest form. Fierce creatures, check. Powerful spells, oh yes. Amazing planeswalkers, yup. An immersive, unique setting that comes to life through the coolest fantasy artwork on the planet. That too. express yourself through the decks you build and the games you play. You know it. Get ready to sling some spells. So again, it's a lot of the, we'll put this away for now. I know how to play already. I don't really think too much has changed in the rules. We'll start opening up these decks. We'll just put all this out of the way here. Let's see what we got in here.
Costs one plague card.
cast that spell, so we have Disentomb. It's a sorcery, it's a spell. Return target creature card from your graveyard to your hand, and the graveyard is your discard pile. Merfolk of the Pearl Trident to creature. It costs just one water land card to cast that spell. And see down here at the bottom, it has 1/1. That's one attack and one defense. It takes one hit, it's killed, and it does one damage. We have Murder, destroy target creature. So here's like an instant, you cast it one time, destroy someone's creature just like that. Crinko's Command, another spell. Put 2/1/1 red goblin creature tokens onto the battlefield. Tricks of the Trade, enchantment. Enchanted creature gets +2 to its attack and is unblockable. Spiked Baloth, beast creature. Has trample. We have a goblin battle jester. Goblin creature. Has whenever you cast a red spell, target creature can't block this turn. A Johnny's Sunstriker. Cat cleric creature. Lifelink. Damage dealt by this creature also causes you to gain that much life. That's pretty cool. Because remember, as a player, you do have start off with health points, 20 points. Here is a Chronomation artifact creature, Golem. If you tap any other card, you get to put a +1/+1 counter on him. So if you tap maybe one, or I'm not sure if you tap different cards or just only can do one at a time, but. A flint hoof boar creature. As long as you control a mountain, he gets +1/+1. If you tap him, if you tap another mountain, it also gains haste. A kite sail artifact equipment. Equipped creature gets +1 and has flying. Rocks faith mender. Rhino monk. Lifelink. And then just a little insert. And island. Oh, here's a... not sure what this is called. A shiny card. I'm not sure if that's called a foil. Tormented Soul. Tormented Soul can't block and is unblockable. It's a spirit creature. And so I think we're back there. So that's some decent cards there. Let's check out the next booster. I don't think we have time to do a tutorial. I'll do another video where we'll play a game of Magic. Alright, we have Wild Guess Sorcery. Has an additional cost to cast Wild Guess. Discard a card, but then draw two cards. So that's not bad. It's like a little spell. Disentomb. Guardians of Akrasa. Human soldier creature. It's a defender. A creature can attack. And it's exalted. So whenever a creature you control attacks alone, that creature gets +1/+1. That's pretty cool. And you can see here, it's creature. This is only a defense, because you can see down the bottom, it's a 0 and a 4. So it has no attack power. But by being on the battlefield, it gives your other creatures that little exalted bonus. Hydro Surge. Instant. Target creature gets -5 to its attack. So you would play this, and you can use that on your opponent. Mark of the Vampire. It's enchantment. Enchanted creature gets plus. enters the battlefield, target opponent discards a card. Instant, destroy target artifact. Creature, human rogue. Harbor bandit gets +1/+1 as long as you control an island. Volcanic geyser deals X damage to target. Life, shuffle elixir of formula, immortality, and your graveyard. each land you control. Switcheroo, sorcery, exchange control of two target creatures. Public execution, instant, destroy target creature and opponent controls. Each other creature that player controls gets -2 until end of turn. Prized elephant creature, it gets +1/+1 as long as you control forest. And if you tap a forest and use a land to give it more mana, it gains trample. Trading post, artifact. Different things you can do when you tap one card and you tap this one. I think it's how it works. Another insert. Deck boxes. And the forest. Land. Alright, let's open up this. Sunstriker. Cat Cleric has lifelink. Duress. Sorcery. A target opponent reveals his or her hand. You choose a non-creature, non-land card from it, and it discards. Welkin Tern has flying and can block only creatures when with flying. Fastwood Gorger. Very powerful. 5 attack, 6 defense. Vile Rebirth, instant. Exile a target creature card from a graveyard. Put a 2/2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield. Crimson Muck Wader, lizard creature. Gains +1/+1 as long as you control a swamp. And if you tap two cards and a swamp, generate this card. Kite Sail, Sarah Angel, Flying and Vigilance, Cathedral of War, land. It enters the battlefield tapped and has exalted. That's pretty cool. Another insert and island card. Exile means once something is exiled, I don't think it can ever be used again. Even it doesn't go in your discard pile, it just goes separate area. Another Timberpack Wolf. Canyon Minotaur. Nothing special except it's got plus three. It has three attack, three defense. Giant Scorpion has Death Touch. Any amount of damage this creature deals is enough to destroy it. Wind Drake has Flying. A Johnny's Sunstriker again. Primal Hunt Beast has Hexproof. This creature can't be the target of spells or abilities your opponents control. Garrick's Pack Leader. Already have that. In another deck, Flames of the Firebrand. Deals 3 damage divided as you choose among 1, 2, or 3 target creatures and or players. I guess you can play with more than one player. It says players, so. Fungal Sprouting. Sorcery. Put X 1-1 green sapling creature tokens onto the battlefield where X is the greatest power among creatures you control. So let's say you have a creature that has a plus 3 attack power. You put 3 1 attack, 1 defense, green sapling creatures onto the battlefield. Fervor, enchantment, creatures you control have haste. There's a goblin card, and a swamp land card. 3 boosters to go. Exalted and can regenerate. Ring of Valkus. Artifact equipment. Equipped creature has haste. And you can put a plus one counter on equipped creature if it's red. Alright, Knight of Infamy. Human knight creature. Protection from white and exalted. Public execution. Destroy target creature and opponent controls. Oh, we have that one. Boundless Realms. Sorcery. Search your library for up to X basic land cards where X is the number of lands you control. Put them onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle your library. Insert. Slag. deals 5 damage to target creature. Destroy all equipment attached to that creature. Prey upon sorcery. Target creature you control fights target creature you don't control. Each deals damage equal to its power to the other. Glorious charge, instant. Creatures you control get +1/+1 until end of turn.
Card booster packs, which is 9 times 15, 130.
set or any fat pack that you might consider buying, I definitely recommend it. So, all right, well, thanks for watching. I hope this was relaxing.